Nick, you and I have waited all year for this. It's the most exciting, action-packed 2 weeks in all of sports, and it tips off in today's game between the Akron Zips and the Wisconsin Badgers.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Badgers should have a cakewalk tonight, Dick. What are the keys for them, you think?
Hey, the keys for them should be straightforward tonight. Number one, take care of the ball on offense and play aggressive perimeter defense. Secondly, don't get lazy, man. Attack the basket, grab the glass, get after the boards. Lastly, keep it simple defensively and play as a unit.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court and we'll see how this one plays out. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome.
He makes the block.
Bring it hard or don't bring it at all.
On the dribble, gives it up. He fakes the shot. Now the turnaround jumper. In and out.
Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. He looks for the bomb. Way off target. Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Perfectly executed. He tries a three ball. Off the rim and no good. Three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. They're off into transition. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. The point guard takes the pass. It's good. King is fired up right now, emotional.
Hey, can you blame him, Brad? He's getting it done.
Moving it around the perimeter. Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
Can we get him the ball, though?
Fed the low block. Executes the baby hook. And in and out. The shooting guard takes the feed. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He dials long distance. He hits it.
STOP. This place will be off the charts if they can get a stop here, Brad.
Inside. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. A defensive player beats him to the spot.
You better plug your ears if they get a basket on this possession. And he'll kick it back outside. Reese pump fakes. For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. Trying to pack it inside. Ball comes back out from the post.
Out there, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job of post position and spreading his body and getting the ball.
They work the perimeter. With a bucket and off the mark. And he scores despite the hack.
Wow, let's check out the replay.
inside. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defense post player.
A high screen. Way off target. Gave it up. The shooting guard gets the pass. He looks at the hoop. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Shot clock is dead. On the dribble, gives it up. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
He shoots from the top of the circle. You betcha. On the outside, the shooting guard with the ball. They can't seem to get the ball to go in tonight, Dick.
They have to start making better passes and start going towards the basketball.
At halftime, the Zips are down by four. Wisconsin gave a great rebounding performance in the first half of this one, partner.
I'll tell you, great effort and great poise. That's a sign of a championship team, if you ask me.
Dick, what's going through these young guys' minds now? Here they are. They've worked all season into the NCAA tournament. We've got a half behind us, a half to go, and somebody's got to go home.
Isn't it a shame, Brad, because both these clubs are playing so well. They're such quality teams, but it's going to come down at the end. I think you better be able to convert on that free throw line, and you got to get some easy baskets. I think every basket has been a struggle offensively. They got to find a way to get some conversions in transition.
Watch the defense down in the low block.
See, first, initially, he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebounding position, a good block out, and that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately to block out and get good rebound position.
The center gets the ball for two. Weak looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Looking for a good shot. He attempts the trifecta. Rims out. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
Contact on the shot attempt causes the misfire. Working it around the perimeter. Gave it up. The small forward gets the ball. In and out. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Picks off the lazy pass. Working around the arc. Great defense. The Big Ten. Michigan, Michigan State, Indiana. Some great rivalries and lots of pounding and banging.
Well, you know, Brad, the Big Ten is known for their physical and bruising brand of basketball.
I think a defensive stop on this possession, Dick, will have this crowd just roaring. Hall handles the feed. Tries to get the D to bite. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the York player to seal him off.
Laid it on the outside. They're working around the looking for the open jumper. Let's check in Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Aaron.
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Buried it. This one might go down to the final buzzer.
I call these ones knee knockers, Brad. Close games that can easily go down to the final second.
Timeout's been called, so let's check in with Aaron.
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
I think she's right about that, Richie. And let's go back out onto the floor. That makes it a four-point lead.
These kids are here to fight, Brad.
Shows patience waiting for the reset.
Double team now, bad angle.
Dickie really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining possession because he gets the good angle, and they also have the good entry from the wing.
And the ball goes out of play. Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestler, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
The lead trickles down to four.
Time is either your best friend or your worst enemy at this point, Brad.
They're working around the perimeter. He throws it up from downtown.
Man, he lured the defender to the screen, giving him time to shoot the sweet J.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Number 45 with the fake. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Get ready to bounce back into action here. Looking for a good shot. Hall receives the ball. Goes up for two.
Foul them early and give your team a chance.
And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession or timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Well, here's a look at the turnover situation, Dick. Probably one of the stats that coaches really care about the most.
I'll tell you, definitely, Brad. Turnovers are missed shot opportunities. And without shot opportunities, winning games becomes really difficult.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And the clock stopped with a foul. You talk about a packed house. Look at
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Spencer goes to the line for the first time. Makes the foul shot. Makes it.
Timeout charge. Hey, can we get a drum roll, Mr. Nestler? This one's going down to the last ticks, baby.
Change might be in order, don't you think, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if they changed things up a little bit, Brad.
The power forward receives the pass. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch.
He shoots from downtown. Off the rim and no good.
Dick, I think the better team won, we can say that, and it's heartbreak for the other club, but, you know, you got to win it, keep on going to get to that final Monday night in Napier.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball, they made sure they converted on the free throw line, they did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Wisconsin played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first round opponent.
Mr. Nestler, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me? Nobody will stop them for the second half.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler.